Hi, I'm Hillary. I'm one of the dietitians here at the James A. Haley Veterans Hospital and Clinics in Tampa, Florida. I work with the Healthy Teaching Kitchen program. Today, we're going to be making a roasted beet borscht, which is a soup that originates from Eastern Europe. It can be served hot or cold. It's a really nice, flavorful soup. So to get started here, we're going to take our beets. So this is about 1 pound, which is 2 to 3 medium beets, diced into about 1-inch cubes. If you dice them a little bit smaller, which I actually ended up doing, they're going to cook a little bit more quickly in the oven. So what we're going to do here is take those beets and we are going to add them onto a baking sheet. So let me move a couple of my ingredients out of the way here. So we're going to add them on like so. And these are raw beets. Of course, we're going to roast them so they'll be cooked once we're done, but we're going to start off with these raw beets. Then we're going to take and use our oil, our salt, and our pepper. Now, these three ingredients are divided, so we want to make sure that we're not using all of them. We need 2 tablespoons of our oil. And then we're going to need 1/4 teaspoon of our salt and 1/4 teaspoon of our pepper. Now I have pre-measured them out here. They're all going to end up going to the same place. So I'm going to just shake a little on here and I'll shake a little bit on here. The rest of those we'll save for the next step. Then what we'll do is we'll just take a quick spatula and just kind of give them a stir. Make sure that all the beets are nice and coated with the salt, the oil, and the pepper, and that they're spread out evenly on the baking sheet. Then what we're gonna do is roast these in a preheated oven for about 20 to 30 minutes until they're nice and roasted. So once I get them spread out, give them a little shake to kind of even them out. We'll pop them in like so. So now that our beets are in the oven roasting for that about 20 to 30 minutes, what we can do is go ahead and get started on the next step. So we're going to heat a large pot over about medium to medium high. And once it gets nice and hot, which it's getting close to there, we can go ahead and add in our tablespoon of oil. Then what we're going to be doing is adding in our carrots. So we have 2 large carrots chopped. They're going to get blended up so it doesn't have to be a very precise cut, but you're welcome to, you know, practice your knife skills if you like. And then there is 1 cup of diced onion. So we're going to add those in here in just a moment. So I think our pan is looking pretty warm. So we'll add that tablespoon of oil. Remember, we used 2 tablespoons of the 3 that were divided earlier. Let that get nice and hot and shimmery in there. There we go. And then we're also going to be using our remaining salt and pepper for this portion of the recipe. Leave those there. First, I'll go ahead and add our carrots in. And then we'll add the onion in. So our 1 cup of onions. Our remaining salt and pepper, right? We'll just give this a quick stir. We're going to let this cook for about 10 minutes or so until it is slightly softened. Alrighty, so it looks like it's been about 10 minutes that our onions and carrots have been cooking. Looking pretty good here. So what we're going to do is we're going to add in 1/2 teaspoon of dried thyme. And we're going to add in 2 cloves of minced garlic. I'm going to use a little garlic press here to kind of squeeze the garlic. You could buy the store-bought. You could also mince it with a knife. Either one works. It's really up to you and what your preference is. So we're going to let these cook for almost a minute, maybe not quite, just until they become nice and fragrant. And then we're going to go ahead and add our broth in. Already starting to smell it. So in the meantime, what I'll do is I'm going to go ahead and get our beets out of the oven because They are just about ready. It's been about 25 minutes or so. And there are our roasted beets. So I'm just gonna set those off to the side. Let them kind of start to cool while this room continues to cook. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and add in our 6 cups of low sodium vegetable broth. We're gonna bring this up to a boil and then we're gonna let it simmer, turn it down to a simmer and let it cook for about another 15 to 20 minutes until the carrot is nice and tender. That will give our beets some time to cool as well. So we'll just give it another quick stir here. Make sure everything's kind of scraped off the sides and pop the lid on. Once it comes up to a boil, I'm gonna go ahead and turn it down and then we'll check back in afterwards. All right, so our soup has cooked for about 20 minutes or so. The carrot is nice and tender. And I actually let it cool down for about a half hour or so after cooking it. You don't have to necessarily do this, but I wanted it to cool before I put it in the blender. So we're gonna go ahead and take the top part off and we can actually get started by adding those beets, right? So we'll just simply take the beets. And these could still be slightly warm. I gave it a little extra time and let things cool a bit just so that it's a little bit safer in the blender. Just scrape them all in. Now, if you are working with the food that is still hot, the beets are hot and the soup is hot. Oops, I lost a couple there. You're gonna want to make sure you don't fill your blender overly full. Let's scoop those two in there. There we go. And then what I'm going to use is this little strainer here to go ahead and scoop up the items from my soup. That way I don't end up with too much liquid in there. And you could also pour this through a colander into a separate container, and that could work just as well. So it really depends on what is easiest for you. All right, once we have all of that mixture in, I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of this broth, just enough to help it blend into a nice smooth mixture. So what we're gonna do is remove this plastic part in the center. That gives us a vent for the steam to come out. So we'll go ahead and put this on like so. Then what we want to do is take a clean cloth and we're going to put that over the top so that the soup doesn't splatter out as it blends. So we'll add that on the top, put our soup on our blender. There we go. And we're going to go ahead and blend this for about 2 to 3 minutes until it's nice and smooth. What we want to see is a really nice pureed soup. All right, so that's it. We've got our mixture pureed up here real nice. And we take it off. There we go. You can see that nice purple beady color in there. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is stir it back into our soup pan. And I'm spilling the beets a little bit. Sure I get all that good beet and carrot puree out. What I'm gonna do is just stir this back in. And look at that beautiful color, that beautiful, beautiful beet color. So now what we're gonna do is add in the honey or sugar and the vinegar. So let me grab that. And we'll just keep stirring that until it gets nice and incorporated. All right, so now that our soup is completed, we can go ahead and make the topping. I have some diced green tart apple here, and that's just diced up nice and small. I put a little bit of lemon juice on it to make sure that it doesn't start to get brown on me. The recipe calls for fresh dill, but I didn't have fresh dill today and it wasn't at the store. So you can always substitute dried dill. Just make sure you do a third to a fourth of the amount. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that into my yogurt. And this is gonna be the topping for our soup. So let's just give that a nice little stir there. And there we go, I'm smelling that delicious dill smell. So there's our dill yogurt mixture for the top. So now we'll just take a bowl and we'll scoop up a portion. So a serving is a cup. Let's see how cleanly we can get this into here. And this is such a vibrant color. All right, so there's the borscht. And we'll go ahead and put about a tablespoon of our yogurt dill mixture right in the middle. And what we'll end up doing is kind of swirling that into our soup as we eat it. And we'll just take a little bit of our apple, kind of add that around on the side. There we go. And there is our soup, our delicious roasted beet borscht. So I hope you guys enjoyed that recipe. It's great. You can freeze this soup. It reheats really well. It has a lot of versatility too. So I hope you guys enjoy it. You can eat it hot. You can eat it cold. Make some substitutions to the ingredients if you like. And I hope that you all enjoy it.